You're watching the Python Coder. In this video, we look how to read a file. Do you take out all your money when you go shopping? No. When you're eating snacks and you want to eat some, do you take all of them out? No. In a file, everything is a string. So you could take out all the string. Or you could just take it out by one end. So your choice is read everything or get a piece by piece. Well, how do you do that? When you read a file, you put it all in memory. You could use a file handle to take out parts of the file bit by bit. So what is a file handle? Well, this is an object that points at the file, a bit like this arrow here, and it can go down the file and retrieve bit by bit. So when we want to get data, we can get, for example, line by line. So in a file, you see many different lines. In this example, represented by the different lines of string. But your computer doesn't see that. Your computer sees a continuous string. So how does it know what lines to produce? Well, that's a new line character, this slash n. And that means each line that you see has this new line character at the end. So we have a continuous string, but with these new line characters telling the computer when a new line occurs. Let's have a look at an example. Here's a file with people's names and their scores. Now this is a continuous string. We have the name, a space, a score, which is an integer, and then the new line character. So that's all one string to the computer. So remember, when we get data, we get each line. Each line has the name and the score and the new line character. We don't want the new line character, so we can use strip. So here we've got the data without the new line character. Everything is a string, so if you want to do anything with the numbers as an integer, then you need to change them to either an integer or to a float. So you're converting the type. So first of all, each line we're going to split. So we split it into X and Y, the X being the name and Y being the score. And we want to change the score from being a string to an integer. So here we just use int Y. How about writing to a file? It's the same in the sense that we have this file handle and we've got, for example, the people's names and their scores. We want to write them into a file. Remember, we need to make everything a string. So if you've got numbers, they need to change, or you need to change their type to a string. So again, in our example, we've got the name and the scores, and we need to change those integers to strings. So what do we do when we write? We open a file. We write the name, we write the score, which we change to a string, and then we're going to close the file. So that means the new file that we've created has the people's names and their scores inside. So that makes our new file with the scores in. Let's look at some code, including our example. Here we're going to read everything. So we've got our file called test. It's a text document. We're going to open it. We don't have to use the R, but the R stands for read. So we've got open, then our file name, and then a flag for read or write, for example. And then we're just going to print what the file handle is, .read. So that reads everything into a file. Using a file handle. So here we've got the same code, But instead of reading everything, we're going to use a for loop with the line using a file handle and then print each line. In our example, we had to strip each line of the new line character. So here we see line equals line dot strip. Then in our example, we split the names and the scores. So here we've got x and y equals line dot split. We had to change the string scores into numbers, into ints. So here we've got int of y. And finally, we put our names and scores inside a scores dictionary. So here's the full code for that. There is an alternative method of opening files, and that's using with. So here we have the same code except with open file as file, and then we've got our for loop. We can do the same with read as well, using with. The advantage of with is that you can close the file, so people tend to like that it automatically closes a file after opening it. Remember, if you're going to use file handling, then the file should be in the same folder as your program. If it's not, then there are ways that you can access which folder or directory you want where the file is. But for now, we're going to assume that the file is in the same folder as your Python file. What about writing to a file? Similar code, but here we've got this handle out, and we've got open the file and the W standing for write. We have a for loop, so here we're going to go through all the names and scores in the scores dictionary, and we're going to write the name, which is a string, the score, which we're going to change to a string, so string of y, plus the new character. Remember, we can use the plus symbol to concatenate strings. And then in this example, we're going to close the file, so out.close. If you prefer using with, here's the code, very similar. We don't need to close it after because we're using the with method. One thing to notice, we've got myfile.txt. If it already exists, we're going to write over it. So be careful, if you're going to use a file name, then you're going to delete that file if it already exists in that folder. So be careful there. We're going to finish with some terms. File handle, an object that can access a file. Slash n stands for new line, and that's used to split a continuous string into lines of text, such as in a file. Strip is the function we use to remove unwanted characters, like the new line character, and also unwanted spaces. Read, we're going to put all the text file into memory. Finally, write is the function when we want to put text into a file. Okay, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the like. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. Thank you for watching, and see you for the next video.